Hello, hello, it's Wessel here, and thanks for joining me as I continue on my adventures in SnowRunner on hard mode. And today we're at day 45 here in the Glades. Definitely moving through these contracts now in the Harvest Corp map. So I'm happy that we are going to make some good progress today in our 1 hour session, which equates in SnowRunner time to a day. So this is my day-a-day process. So basically, we are doing the chicken coop task at the moment. We've loaded up 4 metal rolls, and we're going to just cautiously and carefully head on over to the chicken coop. Now, chances are high that we will drop some rolls off at some stage. But we're going to just see how we go if we're cautious and careful as to whether we can make it up and over the grass and then through the field. So let's just have a little look here. What have I got ahead of me? Yes, although I could go this way, I am going to end up... Oh, we might go this way, actually. Oh, clicked the wrong thing. Oh, boy, what are you doing? You're just messing everything up. So let's try and grab that one. Oh, no. Oh, all right, fine. Let's just lose everything. So let's come this way. Kind of, sort of. See how we go with that. I'm just watching out for any great big dips that are going to cause the rolls to just go bouncing off. So it's a bit of a slow and steady pace today. So we've got a little bump there, but we'll go around that. Ooh, it's bigger than I thought. Just going to reverse because we don't want to hit that poor old tree. It wasn't his fault. Go this way and see if we can work our way up. That is quite steep, but as long as we go straight, I'm fairly happy that we should be able to climb up that steep little incline there. Straight, not so good there, not so good, yeah. So that was the obligatory throw the metal rolls off. Bit of a pity. See if we can pick them up and put them back on. I might actually, if we can get them on with a bit of luck. Just up a bit. Steep bumpy bit, actually. Look at this. This is very steep. So I'll just crawl down there. Crawl. Okay, still got our 2 on the back. It's a little bit muddy, but that's okay. Yeah, pretty good. I'm pretty happy with it so far. I'm going to chuck them off once. Go to that knife bottom. Through between the trees here. Ooh, careful of those bumpy bumpies. Just go steady across here. Slow and steady. Can sometimes do okay. Got our two wooden planks already packed. So once we get to the chicken coop here, we'll be able to deliver those, and then we're going to repack the metal rolls. Okay. There we go. We've now got a chicken coop. Where we can keep chickens, I guess. Hooray! Alright. Now. Is it something like... Oh, okay, that's the next task, isn't it? Okay. Now, I thought that we might have had a task pop up here. Which is, what was it called? When luck runs out. But it looks like we haven't got a task pop up here. Can't see one straight away. Oh, there it is up there. Okay. Oh, that's all right. Fine. Eee, spin around a bit. Okay, so I'm going to... what am I going to do? I'm going to stop the engine. And I'm going to switch to the Tayga, which is up here. Because I want to do that task called When Luck Runs Out. So where is it? Over there. So I'll just mark it. Actually, I have no need to take the trailer with me, so I'll just try and get it to the point and just park it a bit. Oh, I do hate the course of these trailers. That's okay. I'll just do a great big wide U-turn around here. This is the task for In Search of Inspiration, which is a scouty type visit here, visit there, visit somewhere else sort of task. And we're going to leave that trailer there and go up and have a look at the new task up here. Which I'm pretty sure involves bringing back a little Khan Lo4f or something like that. Let's go and find it first. Let's then find the task. Okay, when luck runs out. We'll turn that one on. So there's the little guy over there. So we're going to want to go down and get him. I don't think we want to go down too directly. I want to go sort of squeakily wiggly round here a bit. Don't want to... There, I definitely don't want to tip over too hard. I'm not going to go on those rocks. I'm going to sneak around this way. Him a bit. Actually, it doesn't look too bad down here. How about that? Right, and this time we're going to pick him up. I'm going to try to put him in the back. Now, I know the loaf is actually quite heavy. It might be too heavy to pick up at this sort of angle. So we might. Ugh. Restore the grain. We're going to bring it up a little bit closer to the world. A heavy ball. Got him in there, so that's good. So we need to go back and get our trailer because we are going to want that later on. We don't actually need it just yet, but that's okay. Best way to get down to the chicken coop. Actually, you know, chicken coop. Hey, that's, yeah, that's fine. Attached trailer. Couldn't think what I was doing there for a minute. Okay, so we're here. And we're going to come back. Alright, so we've got to come over this way a fair bit. So coming over here sort of thing. We don't have to go through the garage, so we might go around behind it. Actually, I won't mark too much more because I know I sort of want to get down to about here. So we'll just sort of play it a bit like that. Those rocks and got very frightened, but they're not that bad. That's right, we did this last time, we came past the watchtower. Wow, there's the camera. We're so close. I sort of thought we'd be driving for a while. We were very close to the garage. Whoa! Hit that bump pretty hard. Come around the back of the garage. This is a little bit easier. going to be going into the garage, so that's fine. Some nasty bumps there. Try and miss the tree stumps. Ooh, missed the worst of that. So the loaf is empty. I'm happy for the loaf to be empty. Now, I think I'm just going to winch the trailer behind. I was toying with should I put the ramps down and try and put the trailer onto the ramp flatbed. That would be very cute. But I don't think I can bother. Heading down to the chicken coop where we deliver this little kind of loaf. Let me just take the high road just to avoid that mud puddles. Steeper than it looked from further away. We'll go up this one. I like the look of this even this one. Come around that way, around between the trees. Just trying to minimize the extreme up and down nature of it. Starting to get towards the end of the tasks now. Okay, now I expected to deliver that to the same place where the Voron was, but obviously not. you doing? Oh, I've got actually delivering, don't I? Oh, I'm gonna have to repair him. That'd be annoying. Oh. Okay. Well, that's another one of these ones where you think you might be able to get it, but no such luck. Stop the engine there, because I know there's another task that sort of popped up over here somewhere. Yes, Gorn fishing. So we're going to need to head over here for Gorn fishing. So I might just take the Tayga around there and have a look at that one. Meanwhile, the Voron over here, let's just have a quick look. I've got a... No, it's another task, isn't it? Ooh, what's it called? Feeding time. That's the one. Yes, you see there's two hay bales that I have to pick up here. So what I might do is jump into the Voron, pick up the two hay bales that should have yellow arrows. Oh, well, if I held on it, would have feeding time. Give me those two. Right. I'll go and get our two hay bales and then come back and refuel from the fuel trailer that's just around here somewhere. Careful. So that's the first hay bale, so we'll grab that. So we'll stop the truck there and we'll head over and hop into the Tayga. Okay, where's that Tayga? Yeah, so we've got everything sort of over here at the moment and we're going to want to go and get... spin around. We're going to want to go over here, pick this up, bring it back over. So I think we probably want to really leave the trailer and everything pretty much here. That's about the right spot. So let's take the... Start the engine. Let's take the trailer with us. Yes, it was arguably pointless bringing the ramp flatbed, but we will need it later on. That's why I don't have to go back and get it. Just bring him up a bit more. Down this hill, not through this water, I think. She does look a bit yucky, but I don't think it'll be worse than the world. And then we've got this is going to be one of those farming plot type places. It is pretty much the worst. are going to be another harvesty, what do you call it? Not harvesty, but farmy type thing. We're doing field farming. I knew we'd have another one. It's fine. This looks like it's a bit bigger actually. Just detach them here. And I'm gonna just go back and refuel. Okay, so we're fully fueled up. Head on now, see if we can not do hay bales and feeding time. But we're actually going to head over to Gone Fishing, which I haven't got as a task yet, so I'm going to see how to get there. Don't like those rocks everywhere there, so I think we might stay away from the rocks. That does look fairly steep coming down there. I think we should be okay. But we'll see how we go. We'll get to about there and see how we go. So, whoa! Oh! Right, so there was quite a lift there, which I didn't even see. Edge our way down over there. That's the way. Ooh. Okay. Be careful of that one in the future. Watch out for that. That's not very nice. Yeah, so over this side of the map, rather obviously, we've got some pretty deep. So let's have a look at that water's edge. It's suddenly looking a lot more appealing, isn't it? So we might just have a little look down at that water's edge. I've not been down there before, so let's see how we go. Definitely this will be good in a scout. I'm not sure the Tayga is the right tool, but that's okay, because we're going to hit this one here. So that's pretty good. Yeah, that's fine. So now I've got a choice. Do I come down near the water's edge? I think I do. Here's a blue marker. It looks like it's one of the ones for In Search of Inspiration. So given that I meant to actually click, I've done that a few times, haven't I? Haven't actually done it. So we're visiting the southern lake. Nice. There we are. Done. So next we have to visit the northern lake. There's a task just over here. You can see there's a little truck in the water as well. So let's see if we can turn around without falling over. We'll pretty much come back the way we came, I think, because that actually worked out pretty well. Just got to be careful when going back across those big humps. Fishing task. Just wonder if we might be better off to come across that little island. And up this side. It's probably six, one half dozen the other, isn't it? We might as well stick with what we know. Come on, fisherman's truck, you can do it. Where is the fisherman's truck in it? It's not like it's a little tease there or something like that. So we'll do our same trick that we did with the Khan Lo4f. We'll pop this little guy in. Spin, did it? Right. So we've got the fisherman's car. Let's go back the way we came. Carefully. Meet up with the trailer and ramp up it again. Because actually it's nowhere near as bad as I thought it was going to be. Have a quick little peek, make sure I know where I'm going. Oh, I'm going almost perfectly. So I'm heading literally to here. Pretty much straight ahead, so. Just missed that big hump. That side of that one. Wasn't it? So now we are going to the airport. So I think actually here is not quite the right place to left the trailer, but that's okay. This Too close. Okay, so I'm just going to stop the engine for a second and see where I am. Because I was thinking I had to go back to the warehouse, but I don't. I'm actually going to the airport. Over there. So I'm thinking, so I'm here. So I want to come past my mate in the Voron. Probably along this field, really. And because this worked fairly well the last time, we'll do a variation and come back this way. Something like that. Okay. So we've got to, actually, I'm going to go back a little bit because I've got to go behind myself there. So I did mess that up a little, didn't I? Field work. So, because we've still got to do all that field work, I'm going to need fuel there. So I'm going to leave it here. We'll pick it up on the way through later. Not a huge amount of fuel left in it, actually. I know, this is a stupid way to do it, but anyway. To the Tayga. Right, so the Tayga's fully fueled. The Voron's fully fueled. So, what we might do is switch back over to the hay feeding time and head up. We pretty much just want to go over these hills, sort of heading up more in this direction and then over in this direction to get the hay bale. So let's see how we go being able to do that. Service trailer. What's that doing there? I didn't leave that there, did I? Oh, I wonder if I did. I reckon that's the service trailer that I was bringing. Okay. I reckon that's the service trailer that I need for the... Oh, wow. for the task that I was taking over to the corporate warehouse, and somehow it's detached, and I've left it there. That's a bit sad, isn't it? Oh. These things happen sometimes. I will actually come and get that pretty soon, to be honest. I might use the Tantra Force to come back and grab that while he's over there. Should have been doing. Zoop zoop, go back and get him. Changed my mind, I realised late there. Changed my mind. So there's a task that I can do on my way. Contract of something. It's just reminded me. But where's that trailer? There it is. Is I think I was pulling it behind the heavy semi-trailer for that task to deliver the heavy semi-trailer. I'd say it's fallen over and as I've done something, I've forgotten to go back and get it or something like that. It's okay. We will happily grab it now and hopefully we'll be able to sort of go and stand it up at the same time. There is still a task for that one, which I'll have to do. But where's the warehouse? Oh, wow, okay. Warehouse is nowhere to be found. The warehouse where I want to be is over there. That's the spot I'm heading to. Come way further down to the south than I expected. So let's get back. Get caught on something because he's like sideways. Oh, he's not sideways anymore. Oh, that's good. He did get caught on something. Let's get away from that tree. Oh, come on. I don't know how far I have to go to get away from that tree, but anyway. Again, we will definitely get away from it this time. It'll be way over here. Well, that was lucky that I found that, because I'd sort of forgotten about that task. We are going to use the force to do that one, so I'm not going to get too fussed about it. However, there is another contract I can do. Keep Refrigerated. Now, this is the one that we had two vehicle spare parts here before. You can see them. There they are. So we'll do a little bit of fiddling around now. Take these pay bales off for a second. And then we'll load up the vehicle spare parts. Couple of metal beams and take them the massive distance they have to go to complete this task. him on top for a second. So we're going here. Take that first one off and then try and load some metal beams on. First set of metal beams. I'm trying to make the second set of metal beams on. Two metal beams, two vehicle spare parts. Go, Keep Refrigerated is now done. So we get another warehouse. I don't know where that warehouse is, but we get it. Oops, wrong way, wrong way, wrong way, wrong way, wrong way. No, you messed that right up. Grab our hay bales back. Chuck them in. Go back to our task that we were doing called feeding time. Right, we've got to get that last hay bale from over there. So from here, it's pretty much follow the road actually. Get it. Now I'm actually now just a tad worried about fuel, to be honest. But we'll see how we go. Sunflower field. Yes, basically I want to try and get to this hay bales, finish it, as in get pick it up and then deliver it and make it back to the garage if I can. Field, I think. So where was I heading? Ah, okay. I'm heading up. Oh, is that where the hay bale? Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's where the hay bale is. Fine. No, I'm not doing hay bales tasks though, am I? Now I'm doing it again. So let's go and grab this hay bale. The ditch here. Pick up this other one and take it over to the buyer. This guy on his mate. Yes, I can. Alright, so now we're heading over to the buyer, and to be honest, we're just going to go pretty much straight to about there, up and through there. Sometimes going through the fields is good, sometimes it's a bit muddy. This one's pretty good. There are three hay bales we need to deliver here. Look at that, feeding time is now done. So that's pretty good too. So in search of inspiration, it's over there. It's a bit of a way, but not too far. So it's a bit of a way away from heading to the garage, but kind of in the same world. Not picking it. So we're going to want to head down this side of the river, I think. So we'll head over to here somewhere and then over to there. Kind of. So let's spin around. I'm a little bit concerned about fuel, obviously, because we ain't got a lot. So we might run out. If we do, I will... do I need this trailer anymore? Let's just stop there for a second. Stop. What still has to happen? I've still got to do in search of... what do I got to do in contracts? Bulk loading, which is like 8 loads of potatoes. Bleah. Like hot potatoes. I've actually already done that, but that's fine. Comms tower. Ah, that's the one that needs the service trailer. Yep. So I can do that very quickly with the Tatra Force. I can grab that trailer and nip it over there to do comms tower. So that's nice and easy. Comms tower. Not so high voltage is medium planks. And I'm going to do that with the Tayga after I've dropped off the little TZ or whatever it was at the airport, so I can load up 3 medium planks and take them off to the various damaged poles. So there's one at the top there. There's one obviously there in the middle of the farm. And there's one there. Yeah, okay. So that'll be the Tayga. And then wind turbine, which is the delivery of heavy trailer. So we don't have to worry too much about that. So I don't think I need my sideboard semi-trailer anymore. Cool. Detach the trailer. I just don't need it. And if I do need it, I'll be a bit annoyed. And I'll have to come back and get it. But at this stage, I think we won't be using the Voron to do any more deliveries. So we're starting to get towards the end now. Got to come over here to visit the northern lake. And then I think I've got one at the western lake, something like that. And I'm going to use the little TUZ for that because he's already sort of over there. Just to be brave, I'm going to run out of fuel. I'm not going to go on to that blue marker. I'm just going to go past around the top here. Close enough. Come on, close enough. Yeah, we'll do. Careful, careful. And it's getting pretty light. Whoa, look at that jumper. So we might just make it over here to this spot. But I don't think we're going to make it back to the garage. Western Lake to go. And I think I'll just come around here this road a bit. I think we're going to head back to the garage, but I don't think I've got time to do that today. We'll have to call it a moment. Let's just get up on this hill so I can see everything. Well, there's the airport there. I'm starting to learn where things are now. Okay, oh, the corporate garage is over here. Good thing I looked. So the corporate garage is back over this way. So let's... And we've still got 45 minutes of game, which is about 2 minutes of our time, maybe even less. But it won't take as long to nip over there unless I fall over something. Let's not get stuck in the water. You have to take the Voron back and put it away, because this is pretty much the last thing I think we're going to be doing with the Voron here. Still got a bit to do with the Tayga, I think, with its sideboard semi-trailer. But, really happy that we've got the Voron here. Now, I'm a little bit nervous about parking it in the garage yet because it's so low on fuel. I don't really want to put something away with no fuel in it. So we'll stop there. That is probably the end of the day. Oh, near enough. So I'm just not sure how I'm going to refuel this guy. We'll have to work that out at some stage. I just don't know at the moment. We'll hop into the Tatra Force because he is going to take that service trailer out to the power station, whatever it was, so he can complete the contract. Just can't remember what it was called. Let's just come back in here, turn around. We're going to park next to the got the water guy. I wondered why. I just didn't seem to get him anywhere there. Got him attached. It's just after 8. Perfect stopping time. Wow, we've done well today. We have knocked over so many different things today. It's been one heck of a good day. We finished when luck runs out. We've started gone fishing. We've finished feeding time. We're 2/3 of the way through in search of inspiration. And we finished chicken coop. So we have just done task after task after contract today. So tomorrow we'll come back, we'll do comms tower with the force. We'll then hop over to the Tatra and take that little TUZ or whatever it is that we've got in the back and take that to the airport, drop it off, and then pick up 3 medium planks to carry out to the broken telegraph poles. For the so-called not-so-high-voltage contract, and finish that too. So by the end of tomorrow, I reckon we're literally only going to have one contract, the wind turbine one, to go and get the great big heavy trailer. Plus bulk loading, which is all of the 8 loads of bloomin' yucky old patooties. What is it called? The out in the field, the actual farming task. So we've still got farming tasks. We're going to be doing a lot of farming tasks. Ugh, really annoying. But that is what it is. We're going to have to do like 10 of them. So I may or may not even video that. We might just skip that and say, hey, I did 10. Yay. We will see. Anyway, that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. And hopefully you'll join me again tomorrow when we really will kick some bum and just about finish off most of the contracts and tasks here, sure, except for those farming ones. Thanks for watching. Bye for now. Bye bye.